game, and you're a big player in today's game as well. Let's get the party started. Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And we are underway from Atlanta. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. And give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 45. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive.
How many times when we see an incomplete pass, we just look at the receiver and say, ah, should have caught that one. That was a drop, and we just put it on the offense. How about a little credit for the defense there? They just forced an incompletion.
Yeah, especially after starting in a tough spot defensively, but a good start there on first down.
That gave them a little extra confidence there, starting, as you said, in a tough spot and being able to make a play on first down.
A solid pickup of 13 sets them up first and goal.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jadeveon Clowney in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And out of bounds all the way down at the 2-yard line. Really nice gain on the completion. However, still third and goal that they face now. This defense hasn't let them in yet. They'll need to stiffen here. Third and goal from the 2. They'll try and run. Tomlinson. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Only a yard that time, so now a decision to be made here on fourth and goal.
Fourth down, ball's at the 1-yard line. Do you go for it, or do you go ahead and kick a field goal? I think because you're going to end up giving a long field.
And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Terrell Pryor taking it in. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. Well, they just put a little sizzle in their steak there. First quarter, fourth and goal, run it in. A boost.
I think they showed confidence in their defense by going for it. That's telling their defense, look, we're counting on you guys, and we know that we believe in you because we go for it here. Even if we don't get it, get field position on our side, and you'll stop them. Instead, they put it in the end zone and tally up 6 points.
Now this offense about ready to take over again. Shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Oh, he can't hang on. That was a dream chance for any D lineman to possibly get a pick. But instead, it falls down incomplete. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Check back. Wide open receiver complete. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. And that one results in 35 yards. To throw now on first down. Flush to his right. And this time not quite to the 30. He'll be down at the 31-yard line. He'll wind up getting 9 after tucking it and running, so it'll leave him with 2nd and 1 yard. Just 1 yard to go here on 2nd down. He'll try and run for the first time with Freeman. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. Only a gain of 1 yard, but that's all they needed, as that's going to move the chains. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Now back to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 29. And he will take this across midfield and down to the 48-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They run with LT as he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
2nd and just 1. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn. They stay on the ground, Tomlinson. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. Only a gain of 1 yard, but that's all they needed, as that's going to move the chains.
2nd and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe 1 yard. Stop short of the 35.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun, eluding the pressure right. And some space here. Give him 7 there on the tuck and run, and they're in better shape now for 3rd.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Set up to throw. He's got a man. It's his fullback. And heavy contact. He is knocked down hard. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. Coming up to the line, and they will need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. They'll look to throw here on first down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Under pressure, and he'll go down back at the 26-yard line.
Well, when defensive coordinators game plan to put pressure on a quarterback, they often want to use blindside rushes, and that's exactly what they did there. The quarterback gets to him and drops him.
And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. And the lead moves to 10-0. So it goes down as an 8-play drive, and they cap it with the field goal.
Yeah, they were able to pick up a few first downs along the way, but they couldn't keep the momentum going all the way into the end zone.
And here now the offense heading back out there. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here, as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. Back to throw now on first down. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Johnson. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. A gain of 6 there on first. And again this time to the tailback. Looking for a seam but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage and that's it. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. Out of the gun now on third down. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. He's picked off near his own 48. And a potential turning point as they'll get the football in very good field position late in this first half. And a great spot to start this drive from here. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. Incomplete. And we're down to 8 seconds now.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Second down now after the incompletion. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. And this one is right down the middle. Sorry, Larry, your hard work appreciated by so many men and women, but not today as we get back to the action in the second half. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. So here they come, the road team now getting the football first to start this third quarter. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because what you really want to do, even though you know this...
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Champ Bailey in there to get him for a loss of 5.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Let go!
They'll run it now out of the gun. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
But no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
And here now the punter, Martin, booming this one away. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And the offense will come back out deep in their own territory. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he rifles one incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Oh, he's got a little damp. Devontae Freeman, they're not going to get him. He's at the 40. 20, 10, and all the way in for the touchdown. Devontae Freeman, 87 yards. And his guys are able to make this a close game again. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there's an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession. That was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you'd think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. So it can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah.
And he lost the football, and this is going to get out of bounds, so they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to the football as well.
Now, I have to admit, partner, that I've often thought that I don't like this rule, where the offensive player fumbles the ball, it goes out of bounds, and they get to keep it.
That's just because you're a defensive guy. That's why you don't like it.
Yeah, you're right. It is a slanted view, isn't it?
But this is nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. They'll call that a punt of 59 yards. Tough to do better than that. And out will come the offense as they take over. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, and their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. Do they want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now?
A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
They'll set up a throw. And this one's incomplete. Six-time Pro Bowler Calvin Johnson, the intended target. And it's third and short. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't he? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
On third down, that's Sanders. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. He needed a yard. That's what he got. And it's going to earn him a new set of downs. Back to the ground, this time with Freeman. And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Moss. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs. Down, he'll drop to throw it. Flush to his right, finding room inside the 40. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
On that play, as you saw the route start to develop downfield, I got the sense that maybe the run would set up for him. And he took full advantage of it and got a big gain on a busted play.
They'll drop to throw. Now he's flushed out right. And he's got some space here. And down inside the 15 he goes. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards. Back now in Atlanta. As we're about ready to rock and roll for the fourth and final quarter. This is Freeman on first and 10. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding him to no gain.
Freeman again. And he's going to get about four down inside the 10 to the 9.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up the fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
All right, so this one's now back within a field goal, and if anybody tells you they see how this one's going to end, I'd have to say they're probably lying, Charles.
And this game's had more twists and turns than a good mystery novel, and I have a feeling we've got a few more twists and turns in store for us before they shake hands here.
And now back out comes the offense. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning.
There's definitely contact there, but it's the fourth quarter of a kind of tight game, and sometimes the officials just say, let them play. Kind of like your mom used to, you and your brothers, just take the broom to you and send you out to the backyard and tell you to settle yourselves.
I like that, yeah. There was contact, I don't know, like you said, enough to warrant the flag. It was close, though. Eluding the pressure right. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Anthony Barr.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit, and receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. There's a guy lurking, took the ball for
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open?
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much. Maybe a yard down to the 23.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. They'll run it now out of the gun. Call it an 8-yard gain. Much better shape now on third and just a yard.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
They'll look to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they needed to keep the drive going. They'll run it now out of the gun. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Oftentimes when a guy has a game like this, he's going to take his offensive line out to dinner afterwards. But after a play like that, he may tell him, instead of getting the steaks, guys, we might have to go for the hot dogs.
And he is knocked down from the side. Now here's whistles and another timeout. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. He's back to throw. And it's caught. Touchdown. Julio Jones from 13 yards out. And his guys have taken the lead here in the fourth.
Wow. I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
The score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
Now this offense ready to head back out there. They're down here in a one-score game, but the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
Yeah, they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Back to throw. His throw incomplete.
I wouldn't be shocked at all right now if there's a look of surprise on the big fella's face, because he had the route that he wanted, running the corner. And usually he's able to use his body and catch the football. But a really nice play by the defenders, able to knock it away.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. Back to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
They tried to make something happen, but that one came up incomplete and really wasn't a good-looking throw.
Yeah, maybe even go as far as to call that a little ill-advised.
Yeah, I would say so. I think that's the right phrase for it. Definitely ill-advised. Just wonder about his mechanics right now, you know, and that's the tough part. You do so much stuff in practice to make it repetitive, but it has to repeat under pressure, whether it's pressure from the defense or just the pressure of playing the game.
This offense so far on third down, they've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is third and 10. He'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And the return will stop right around the 25. Boy, what a turnaround. They exited the lockers with a nice lead, and now all of this. What's happened?
So when you start to write your novel, you'll start out with, it was a tale of two halves, won't you?
Well, hey, but I'm a bad writer.
I don't know exactly what happened, because sometimes teams can go in with a lead and get too comfortable, too relaxed, and a couple things go wrong, and it's hard to get back that good feeling.
Victory very much in sight now as they'll take a knee. Well, as always, partner, an extreme pleasure to share a booth with you. I have to say, I am impressed at your discipline, because you came here and you said you were not going to eat any of the media buffet. You made it to the end. You didn't consume a single calorie.
I appreciate that. What you missed is me going to the concession stand outside of your eyesight and getting it done
cheated.
That way. Look, I mean, they were serving the good stuff. I had to do it.
Oh, man, but you're svelte, in good shape, but yeah, you cheated a little bit. We'll let it slide.
I appreciate that. Always a pleasure to work with you.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. This has been Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Join the discussion on Twitter at EA Sports _MU.